So we're told that h of x is equal to the negative cube root of 3x minus 6 plus 12. And what we want to figure out is, what is the inverse of h? So what is h inverse of x going to be equal to? And like always, pause the video and see if you can figure it out. Well, in previous videos, we've emphasized that what an inverse does is a function will map from a domain to a range, and you could think of the inverse as mapping back from that point in the range to where you started from. So one way to think about it is we want to come up with an expression that unwinds whatever this does. So if we say that y is equal to h of x, well, we could say that y is equal to the negative of the cube root of 3x minus 6 plus 12. This gives us our y, and you could think of y as a member of the range in terms of what our input is, in terms of a member of the domain. But we want to go the other way around. So what we could do is we could try to solve for x. If we solve for x, we're going to have some expression that's a function of y. We're going to have that being equal to x. And so that would be the inverse mapping. Another way you could do that is that you could just swap x and y and then solve for y. But that's a little bit less intuitive that this is actually the inverse. So actually, let's just solve for x here. So the first thing that we might want to do is let's isolate this cube root on, let's say, the right-hand side. So let's subtract 12 from both sides. And we would get y minus 12 is equal to the cube root of, it's actually the negative cube root. Don't want to lose track of that. Negative cube root of 3x minus 6. And then we subtracted 12 from both sides. So that 12 is now gone. And now what we could do, well, we could multiply both sides by a negative 1. That might just get rid of this negative here. So we multiply both sides by a negative 1. Negative 1, and then we multiply this times a negative 1. On the left-hand side, well, that's the same thing as 12 minus y. And on the right-hand side, we're going to get the cube root of 3x minus 6. And now, and this is going to be a little bit algebraically hairy, we want to cube both sides. So let's do that. So let's cube both sides. And actually, it doesn't get that algebraically hairy because I don't have to expand it. I can just leave it as 12 minus y cubed. And so if we cube both sides on the left-hand side, we're just left with 12 minus y cubed. And on the right-hand side, well, you take the cube of the cube root, you're just going to be left with what you originally had under the cube root sign, I guess you could say. And now we want to solve for x. Let's add 6 to both sides. So we're going to get 12 minus y cubed plus 6 is equal to 3x. Now we could divide both sides by 3, and we're all done. Divide both sides by 3, and we get x is equal to 12 minus y to the third power plus 6 over 3. And so this, if you have a member of the range, one way to think about it, if you have a member of the range y, this is going to map it back to the x that would have gotten you to that member of the range. So this is the inverse function. So we could write h inverse of y is equal to this business, 12 minus y cubed plus 6 over 3. And like we said in previous videos, this choice of just calling y the input, well, it could be anything. We could call that star. We could say h inverse of star, and we're just naming our input star, is equal to 12 minus star cubed plus 6 over 3. Or if we just want to call the input x, we could just say h inverse of x. And once again, this is just what we're calling the input, is equal to 12 minus x to the third plus 6 over 3. Might be a little bit confusing because now, in theory, x could be considered a member of the range and we're mapping back to a member of the domain. But either way, we can call the input function to a function practically anything. But there you have it. That is our inverse function that essentially unwinds what our original function does.